Hey, have you ever wondered how you can support multiple languages in your application and that to multiple countries? We're going to see in this video. Hi everyone, this is Subrat and you are watching Funna Futuristic. So on this channel, we'll make videos like this, which is related to programming and web development. So please consider subscribing and hit the bell icon, and don't forget to hit the like button if you haven't yet. You must have wondered, or you must have tried to support your application to multiple languages and to multiple countries. We say that as localization and internationalization. Just to simplify, what it means is supporting your application with different languages to different countries. So in countries, what it meant is like date format, different currencies, and all those things. So to achieve localization and internationalization, there might be two ways. One way is you ask your server to serve the data by translating it according to your request. And in your request, you serve them the local. Here, local is your combination of your languages and your country. So that's the one approach. And it's quite easy for the front-end point of view. It makes sense if you have a bigger application which supports large amount of data and all. But if you have a small application and if you don't want to get all your data from server, all your data means all your fixed data which not going to change, all your static data which will be there in the site, then you can use this approach which we'll going to discuss in the video. And for this, we'll use a package from Angular which is Localize. Before proceeding to the coding, I would like to explain you what is the difference between Localize and internationalization. Think like you want to support your application to various international location. Some countries have different date formats. Some countries' currencies are different. Supporting them is internationalization. Then you can localize them with different languages. That's what localization means. And to see that, I have created a small application where we'll try to see how you can support different languages and also how we'll support RTL, which is right to left, for those countries like Arabic countries and so on. So we'll go to our application. So here, as you can see, I have a small application, which is quite simple. Just a heading, an input field, and a submit button. Before you start coding for your localization, you have to take this thing in your mind that your application alignment will going to be changed. Means right to left and left to right, both need to be supported. So you should not put any styling specific to left aligned or specific to right aligned. So while adding styling, you need to think about that you are adding the styling for the both the variant. Here the variant means one is right to left and one is left to right. So by thinking that in mind, and once that is sorted, then you should think about what all can be localized or internationalized here. So in this particular example, what we can internationalize or what we can localize for different languages is this heading, this placeholder, and this button. If you have some date and some currencies, that also can be done. But the good news here, our date by default supports internationalization. So first thing first, to have our application internationalize, what Angular support or how Angular deals with it, is you create different bundles for different location. Suppose you want to serve for US, it's one bundle will be created for EN-US. Suppose I want to support it for RTL language like Arabic, then one bundle will be created for AR and AE. So why Angular do like that? Our user usually don't change the language that much. So doing it runtime will be more expensive than doing it in build time. So what we'll do now is we'll build our application with various languages, and while serving it, we'll serve it from different location itself. Suppose you are supporting three languages, then you have three instances of your application which will support three different languages, and you can route your user respective to those applications. So keeping that in mind, first we need to add this ng add at angular slash localize. And once you add it, you can see that in your package.json, you have a dev dependency of angular localize. And notice here it's a dev dependency, not a dependency, because as I told, we need the localization function, or we need to translate the file in our build time, not in our runtime. So once it has been added, so we'll go to our angular.json file. Here we need to add like this. And I forgot to say that internationalization is famously known as I18N. And we are seeing that our source locales is ENUS. So what I meant by local is this, your language hyphen your country code, your language code and your country codes. So that's what a local means. And we are saying is our locals will be here ARAE. I'm just showing you ARAE because I want to show you the both the language. For English, it will be left to right, and for ARAE, it will be right to left. So the both the condition will be satisfied. And here you can add multiple locals with different language code and different country code, and that will also going to work. So we'll just see here two language, one is English and one is Arabic. What we are seeing here is our translation file should put here, which we'll going to create, and we'll say that our base href will start with ARAE. Then you'll go to inside our architect and a build and the option. So while building a project, you need to put this. You're saying, I will localize my project for ARAE. Similarly, you can pass different local here as well. So what it will do while building your project, it will create different bundles for different locals. So once that is done, now I'll go to our application and see what all we can do to change the language. It's quite easy. So suppose I want to change this submit button. So what I just need to do is I just need to add I18N here. And it will say that, okay, my submit button has a I18N tag on it. So when we'll create our translation file, it will pick this and try to give us a placeholder. So similarly for placeholders, what we need to do. So I'm just saying it for placeholder, it will act for any attributes. Okay, so suppose for I18N, then hyphen, then you will just say placeholder. So why I'm saying any attribute, suppose you have an image and you want to put alt text or Arial level as different language, because that's what makes sense. So if you're having Arial level for an image, then you should put that to two different languages. So then in that scenario, it will be I18 alt text and so on. You might be wondering, like, if I just put I18N here, will that going to work? Because this is a variable, right? So how we're going to handle it, you go to the TS file, and here where you are declaring your variable, there we just need to put $localize. Now this will be grabbed by our localization functionality and we'll get a placeholder for that. So here hop up work is done. So now we just need to extract all this I18 command and put our translation text in it. Okay, so for that we have ng extract hyphen i8n, and we need to put our output path to source and locale. And when we press enter, it will create a message file or a translation file inside our folder, which we have here. And if I'll go to our angular.json, here you might have noticed I have done a mistake here. So instead of ES, what you can write is AR. It's just to specify different translation file for different locals. So here what you are saying is, for our ARAE local, our translation file should be this. But if you go here and check, we don't have our messages.ar-xlf. What we'll need to do here is we need to copy this file and rename this according to our locale. And in this scenario, our locale is ARAE, so messages.ar.xlf. Our file is ready now to serve. So we'll just walk through once that what is got generated here. So what we have here is all of our text, like enter your name, submit, hello, how are you, which all we have given. Submit, enter your name, and in our TS file, hello, how are you. And if you see here, we have source as enter your name, and you have context group where it's showing the file, which is app component.html, and then line number. What you need to do now, if you have a translator by yourself, you pass this translation file. So in this scenario, our messages.ar.xlf to your translator who can translate for you from English to Arabic. But in this scenario, we'll do that. We just need to add one target. So we'll add target for all three of these. And I will just add Arabic version of this English from Google Translator, and I will be back. So I have added all the target for our source for our Arabic file. Now we'll see how you're gonna use it. So I'll just do ng serve. So if you're doing only one language, so suppose in your AngularJSON, if you have only one localize, so this one will be picked by your ng serve, and it will serve by default. If you'll go to our application, now our application is with Arabic and with right to left. And if you'll try to go back to English, then you'll see we have left to right. RTL is by default supported by Angular. Similarly, the dates currency is by default supported. So now I'll going to show you how I'm gonna actually build it, and while deploy it, what you should think in your mind. So now we'll build our application. To build, you just need to add ng build --- localize. So what it will do, it will go to your localize array and try to grab all the possible locales you have given, like ARA, ESPR, for India, for all other countries. It will try to generate different bundles for you. And we're just going to see now, it will now create two bundles for us, like one is ENUS and one is ARA. So our build is completed. Now we'll go to our dist folder here. And here, as you can see, now we have two folder inside our application, which is ARA and ENUS. So to serve this and to see it in action, we'll go inside CD dist and we'll go inside Angular lang. So I'm running HTTP server on port 4800. I have opened these two languages side by side. So with one single code base, now we have different languages and with different layout. So you just saw how easy it is to localize and internationalize your application. And we saw that we can put different languages as well as different layout. Layout here is RTL and LTR. So our Angular localize package is helping us to achieve all this with few lines of code. Of course, you will need to have a translator who will translate for you, or you yourself will going to translate all your English to different languages. But apart from that, it's just piece of a cake. So if you liked what we have discussed till now, and if you're going to use it in your project, please hit the like button so that it will motivate me to make videos like this. Please do share this video among your friends, family, colleagues, so that they will also make their application to internationalize them and localize them, and they will be famous. We're going to meet in the next video. Till that, stay happy. Bye-bye.